Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. This video we have a bunch of new things posted and new information to do with standard SpaceX updates. Then over to Boca Chica where once again lots of work has been going on and now we know SN8 testing is up next. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off today, as you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the launch of Starlink 12 has once again been delayed. It's now expected to lift off on Thursday at 1:17pm UTC or 9:17am EDT. SpaceX have also tweeted an update about another launch coming up soon. They said, static fire test completes, targeting Tuesday, September 29th for Falcon 9's launch of the GPS-free Space Vehicle 4 mission. In terms of upcoming launches, apparently the Air Force has cleared SpaceX to fly two upcoming GPS satellites on flight-proven boosters. There is a new article from NASA Spaceflight about the next Falcon Heavy launch. A Falcon Heavy side booster was recently seen in McGregor having been raised vertical for a static fire. Eric Berger has also recently tweeted that somebody at SpaceX has confirmed that they are testing a Falcon Heavy booster in McGregor. And apparently Walter Lauderdale said the Air Force is targeting late spring for the USSF 44 mission that will use three new boosters. With even more upcoming launch information, there is a new article from NASA. They have awarded SpaceX a new contract to launch their future interstellar mapping and acceleration probe mission, which includes four secondary payloads. There was recently another new article posted that says the Air Force was impressed by Starlink's performance in a live firing event earlier in the month. Apparently, a federal judge plans to deny SpaceX's challenge to Air Force contracts awarded to its rivals, writing in a sealed court filing that the Pentagon properly assessed the development of Musk's Starship rocket system as too risky and expensive. I also want to show you this shot posted by astronaut Thomas Pesquet, a member of the Crew 2 mission expected to launch next year. You can see the four crew members posing in a Crew Dragon as they currently train for their flight. Another picture to show in terms of future crewed missions is this image posted by Victor Glover, an astronaut for the Crew 1 mission. You can see all four crew members in their spacesuits having completed the Dragon Rider training. As I said, lots of standard SpaceX updates to cover and in Texas is no different. Firstly, you can see that work is continuing with the landing pad. Also worked on recently is the mounted pad A, which will see SN8 sitting on it next, but more on that later. Spotted on a roll lift were these tank stands as they moved the roll lift over to the launch area. Over at the tank farm, engineers were seen hooking up a crane to the top of one of their vertical tanks. Then they were seen lifting and moving the tank in order to be rotated so it's horizontal. Finally, it was then placed on the tank stands that we just saw on the roll lift after it arrived at the tank farm. At the launch area, more arrivals were spotted as a bunch of tankers containing liquid nitrogen were seen parked up. Heading over to the production area, you can see that in the yard, a yellow structure was seen being worked on. Also in the construction yard is the high bay for Super Heavy, which we've seen lots of recently. They are getting closer and closer to completion. With that, they are also progressing nicely on the roof for this giant structure as well. Recently spotted was the arrival of a new transport mount piece sitting on the back of a trailer. Moving on, we'll take a little look at some Starship pieces and Raptor information before checking out serial number information. Firstly, SpaceX posted this incredible video the other day of the first static fire of their Raptor vacuum optimized engine. Then, as I said, we'll also look at Starship pieces. Here we have a load of new barrel sections sitting outside along with one of those 5-ring reinforced nose cone ring stacks. Spotted sitting and being worked on inside a fabrication tent is another new ring stack. This one has loads of mounting points for the TPS tiles. As you will know from the last video, SpaceX recently intentionally destroyed a Starship test tank. The intention for this SN7.1 tank was to test various things including the materials and new thrust puck design by seeing how high they could get the pressure. The test looked pretty good with the tank mostly holding up and primarily just blowing its top. Here's the latest view of how the bulkhead looks, but we have yet to hear anything from Elon Musk about what pressure this tank reached. So, as they probably prepare to move the SN7.1 test tank from the launch area, they are also working on SN8 in the construction area. As they finished working inside the tank, they've closed off the little access port for SN8. You will know that recently the SN8 prototype got its body flaps a first since the Mark 1 tank. They also did an actuation test of the fins, as you can see here that they are folded in. I also want to throw in this absolutely amazing shot of the SN8 tank with both its fins attached. Cannot wait until this Starship also gets its nose cone and canards. Talking about the nose cone, you can see at the top of the tank they've already attached lead-ins for stacking the nose. In terms of rollout, we were expecting it to happen yesterday between 7 a.m. and 8 a.m, but it ended up happening around 9:30. It still has yet to be placed on the mount, but doubt it will be much longer. Before we look at testing dates, I want to show you this fantastic photo from Elon Musk of engineers working on SN8. Musk also said that it will get nose cone and canards next week, with SN9 looking to debut next month. As well as this, Musk also said that SN8 would first fly to 15 kilometers in altitude, or approximately 50,000 feet. On the Cameron County website, you can see more dates coming up for SN8 cryo testing, with a primary date of Tuesday 29th and backup dates of Wednesday and Thursday. Moving on from SN8 though, we also have SN10 currently under construction in Boca Chica. Here, the recently sleeved thrust section was hooked up to a crane to be flipped into the correct orientation. Also being built is SN11, and here you can see a new header tank being worked on for this prototype. There was also another new lower bulkhead with thrust puck spotted sitting outside, presumably for SN11. So with that, here is the latest build diagram, once again thanks to Brendan Lewis. The production of these Starship tanks is just incredible now. This is what rapid iteration looks like. As is always the case, a huge thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for going out there and filming every day in the hot Texas heat. Also, a huge thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team, who do amazing work behind the scenes. We are truly grateful for what you do. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.